England means everything to me. The easy choice would be to stay silent. I look at my country, I've got 3 children. It's my duty as an Englishman to make sure that I hand down a safe and prosperous country to them. They can tell people I'm a figure of hate. They can tell people I'm an extremist. The public don't buy it anymore. Most places I go, I get love. I get loved by the public because they've tried to make me a leper because I talk about issues that expose their failures. They have failed with mass migration. They failed with integration. They failed with assimilation. The entire British Parliament have pandered and cowered in the face of ideologies that wish to destroy this nation. They got on their knees for the Marxist Black Lives Matter. They cower in fear in the face of Islam. They dare not even speak about it. There's 1,000 years of English history here, 1,000 years, and they're going to give it away in 60 years. No one since Winston Churchill or William Gladstone, not one single person in that building has spoke about Islam. Bearing in mind how many jihad attacks we've had, we're not even allowed to ask the question. People now are scared to even talk. That's how they've got us. People are scared to even talk. Now, freedom of speech is the most pivotal point on this, because if we can't have the discussion, we can never solve the problems. Thanks to Elon Musk for restoring my free speech. We are desperate for someone to talk about it. Women are scared, parents are scared. They're looking at their country, we don't recognize it anymore. It's now or never for Europe, yeah? We haven't got long left. With the borders opening the way they are, there is a mass immigration which is changing the face of this country forever. Not for the good. No one can say it's for the good. No one. The criminality is going up, the level of violence is going up, terrorism's going up. We're made to feel like foreigners in our own country. We can't speak up. Their labels are far right, their labels are racist, their labels of Islamophobe, gone. Doesn't matter. No one cares now. No one cares. They've overplayed their hand. They've lied and lied and lied. Already should have been a revolution in this country over the rape and prostitution, torture and murder of our daughters in every town and city. Not just the fact that the Islamic gang's done it, but the fact that they knew about it, the police forces knew about it.
It was covered up.
They all let it happen. And they say it out loud. They let a generation of our daughters be kidnapped and raped. And they did not care. We are seen by them as cattle. When we fear them, that's tyranny. When they fear us, that's democracy. We have had enough of mass immigration. No one's asked us, did we want 1 million people imported last year? No one asked us if we want to continually go into war. No one asked us. That's not democracy. No one's asking us the key decisions. You created us. Your weakness, your cowardice to tackle the problem, as you've allowed jihadism and that ideology to grow into such a power in this country. Do you know who's funding everything in this country? Saudi Arabia, Qatar, and Iran. How have they got bases in our capital city? These fascist ideologies. The abuse of human rights in all these countries, they own half the capital city. You're a generation away from losing our country. That's what we are. Yeah. And everyone wants to sit back and watch it happen. I'm a product of the environment. I spoke about Islamic jihad before people even knew what jihad was. But looting is a blueprint for every town and city. You're playing the lottery with our kids. You're playing a lottery with our country. It was 4 refugees who went on a massacre in Paris, blowing stuff up and killing everyone, of migrants in hotels put up, paid for by us, while homeless British people are sleeping here. Half of London's full of ex-military personnel on the streets, freezing to death. And in the hotels, you've got 1,000 Somalians, Iraqis and Afghanis. This is young, military-aged men coming who are aggressive and hostile to our nation with an alien ideology.
Do you have hope for the future of the UK?
You have to have hope. And Anand said, it's too late. Why are you even trying this? It's too late. I said, if everyone had that attitude back in the day, we'd all be German. How can it be too late? We are the majority, but we are running out of time.